Good morning, students. In this video, we will discuss patterns of biodiversity. So, biodiversity has two types of patterns: latitudinal and altitudinal. Altitudinal patterns. And second one is species area relationships. Species area relationships. So these are the two patterns of biodiversity. So now we will discuss one by one. The first pattern is latitudinal and altitudinal patterns. So generally, semi-arid regions and aquatic regions. Semi-arid habitats and aquatic. These two habitats, the biodiversity shows latitudinal and altitudinal patterns. These latitudinal and altitudinal patterns are also called, master gradients. Master gradients. Latitudinal and altitudinal gradients are also called master gradients. If you observe, there is a little biodiversity in polar regions. There is a little biodiversity in poles. It increases in temperate regions, but it reaches the maximum in case of tropical regions. So very little biodiversity present in polar regions. Small amount of biodiversity increases in temperate regions, but it reaches the maximum in case of tropical regions. It is because in tropical rainforests, the tropical rainforests have favorable conditions not only for speciation, but also for variety and number of organisms. That's why the very maximum amount of biodiversity present in tropical regions. And harsh conditions exist in temperate regions only during winter seasons. In winter seasons, so almost it is totally unfavorable conditions. That's why the amount of biodiversity so little less than tropical regions. But the most harsh conditions or very harsh conditions prevails throughout the year in polar regions. So this is the reason. In tropical regions, always favorable conditions. In temperate regions, favorable conditions present, but in some seasons there is unfavorable conditions. In polar regions, throughout the year, unfavorable conditions. That's why, so larger or more biodiversity present in tropical regions than temperate and polar regions. So now we will see some examples regarding that. For example, number of vascular plants in temperate regions 116 to 236 or 0.1 hectare in case of tropical regions. Because tropical regions have favorable conditions, that's why number of vascular plants are this much. In same vascular bundles 28 to 48 in same region in case of temperate regions. So because temperate regions also have favorable conditions, but it does not have that much of favorable conditions when they are present in tropical regions. And same vascular bundles, zero vascular plants, 0 to 10 in case of polar regions. So such type of correlations occurs in other taxonomic groups, whether it is beetles, birds or any other animal groups. Because they have favorable conditions, but in some cases unfavorable, and throughout the year unfavorable conditions. So this is the example number one. And second example, if you take some areas or some countries, then so we observe clearly which region is favorable for the biodiversity. For example, Colombia. So Colombia usually it is located near equator. That's why it has 1400 bird species. And New York, it is near to 41 degree North Pole. So that's why it has only 105 bird species. And Greenland. So Greenland it is almost near to pole, that is 71 degree north pole. It is towards, that's why it has only 56 bird species. If you take India with most land conditions in tropical regions, that's why India also has large number of bird species, that is 1200 bird species. To tropical regions, temperate regions and polar regions. So gradually the number of animal species gradually decreases from tropical region to polar regions. And similarly, Ecuador, one more example, Ecuador, it has 10 times more vascular bundles than 10 times, it has 10 times more vascular plant species than Midwest of USA. It is near to temperate regions, that's why. So Ecuador, it is near to equator. So that's why it has more or 10 times more vascular plants than Midwest of US. So all you know, the tropical Amazon forest, it is also called lungs of planet, because it produces large amount of oxygen. It has large number of species. For example, tropical Amazon forest has 4000 species of plants, 4000 plants and 3000 bird species and 427 amphibians, 427 mammals and 378 reptiles and 125,000 species of invertebrates and more than 2 million species of insects. So Amazon tropical rainforest, it is also called the lungs of the planet. It has large number of species. These are the some examples. And there are various hypotheses for larger biodiversity in tropical regions. So there are various reasons. The first reason is speciation. So speciation means formation of species. So speciation is a function of time. But in temperate regions always or they frequently undergo glaciation. So glaciation kills more number of species. No such disturbances occur in tropical regions. So speciation, it occurs at a time. So that's why large number of biodiversity present in tropical regions. Second one is more solar energy is available in tropical regions. And next reason is the rate of extinction is very low in case of tropical regions. And last reason is reduced competition. So competition is very less in tropical regions because it provides an alternate source of food. So that's why, so competition is very little. So reduced competition also one of the hypotheses or one of the reasons to larger biodiversity in tropical regions. So this is the latitudinal and altitudinal gradients. And second pattern of biodiversity, that is species area relationships, it is very important. Second one is species area relationships. Species area relationships, for this there is a graphical representation, that is this one. So this is the species richness and this is the area. This is straight line, this is rectangular hyperbola. S equal to CAZ, this is the formula. And one more formula is log S equals to log C plus Z log A. So this is the diagrammatic pattern for species area relationship. So what is species area relationship? So in a German philosopher and geographer, Alexander von Humboldt is a German naturalist or geographer. While Alexander von Humboldt exploring South American forests. South American forest, he found the Vitina area. Vitina area, species richness increased with increasing area, but up to a certain limit. Alexander von Humboldt found that Vitina area, species richness increased with increasing area, but up to a certain limit. The relationship between species richness and area, it turned out to be rectangular hyperbola for wide variety of taxa, whether it is beetles or birds or plant species and or any other animal or plant species. But it is on logarithmic scale, and on logarithmic scale it is a straight line. So generally the relationship between these two, species richness and area, it turned out to be rectangular hyperbola. For that this is the equation, S equals to CSZ. But on a logarithmic scale it is a straight line. On a logarithmic scale it is a straight line, and here there is a equation, log S equals to log C plus Z log A. Here S equals to, S means species richness. C is y intercept, and A equals to, A means area, and Z is slope of a line, or it is also called regression coefficient. It is very important. Regression coefficient generally it has value of 0.1 to 0.2. It is very, very important. The value of regression coefficient is 0.1 to 0.2 regardless taxonomic groups of various plant species, whether it is plants in Britain, mammals in New York, or molluscs in Greenland. So whatever the plant species and what is the region, but the regression coefficient, the value of z is always 0.1 to 0.2. but if you measure the relationship between species richness and area for a large scale area like a continent, then the regression coefficient, the value of regression coefficient have come to 0.6 to 1.2. For example, mammals in tropical rainforest of different continents with steeper line of 1.15. So different continents, different tropical rainforests in different continents have large number of mammal species. If you measure the relationship between mammals and tropical rainforests of different continents, then the value of Z is 0.6 to 1.2 with steeper line. So very reduced line with 1.15. Generally the value of Z is 0.1 to 0.2. But if you measure the species area relationship for a continent or for different continent, then the value of Z is 0.6 to 1.2. So this is the species area relationship. It is very important for 3 marks or 2 marks in board exams. So this is the patterns of biodiversity. Now we will look into what is the importance of species diversity to ecosystem. Importance of species diversity to ecosystem. It is very difficult to make people understand by every organism, whether it is small or big. So it is very difficult to make people understand For every organism, big or small, important to ecosystem. For example, a species of tree bird, it become extinct from Western Ghats, or instead of 20,000 ant species, only 15,000 ant species survival on Earth. However, biodiversity or species diversity is very essential for survival of each and every human race. And this species diversity also gives stability, productivity, and ecosystem health. First, stability. So what is stability? So species diversity is very essential for an ecosystem. And communities with more species, they are tend to more stable than communities with less species. In such conditions, alien species are unable to find foothold. And this has been confirmed by David Tillman's long-term ecosystem experiment by using outdoor plots. Next, productivity. Ecosystem with more species diversity is productive than ecosystem with less species diversity. For example, tropical rainforest is more productive than temperate rainforest, because tropical rainforest have more number of species than temperate rainforest, and it also has been confirmed by David Tillman's experiment. Next, ecosystem health. The species diversity or biodiversity is very essential for to maintenance health of ecosystem through various controls or through various checks or positive and negative feedback systems or keystone species. And no species occur in isolation. Rather, so different species are interlinked through various relationships. And it is explained by Paul Ehrlich. Paul Ehrlich proposed Rivet-Popper hypothesis. For decreased biodiversity on ecosystems. How he explained? For example, an aeroplane like an ecosystem. It has more number of rivets. Means it has more number of species. And the removal of rivets does not affect in the beginning of flight safety. If you remove rivets, like parts of the flight, it does not affect the flight safety in the beginning. Like if you remove the species in the particular given ecosystem, also does not affect the ecosystem. But if you remove the main rivets like wings, or if you remove the main keystone species in ecosystem, it poses threat with immediate effect. If you remove the wings, then flight poses to threat with immediate effect. It totally collapsed. Like that, in ecosystem also there are some species, they are very important species, are called keystone species. If you remove the keystone species, the health of ecosystem, it poses threat with immediate effect. So that's why to rich biodiversity is very essential for ecosystem health. So this is the importance of species diversity to ecosystem.